Hey ho adventurers, Pounce here with Celestia, and it's time for another tutorial for Final Fantasy XIV, A Realm Reborn. First off, I need to apologize for taking so long to get this video out, but I had a really hard time logging in over the past weekend, and the weekends are usually when I do most of the work for my channel since those are my days off from my actual job. The good news is Square Enix just added some new servers and increased player capacity on the current servers, so hopefully it will be easier for me to get on and off and get the footage I need. But enough! On to the class guide. Today we're going to talk about the Gladiator class. The Gladiator is the tank counterpart to the Marauder. While the Marauder goes into battle with a large battle axe and a more offensive style, the Gladiator is a master of the shield and one-handed blades, and is, generally speaking, the more defensively oriented tank. In order to obtain this defensive power, the Gladiator does trade off some offensive ability and health when compared to the Marauder. If you feel like playing a more traditional tank-style character, then the Gladiator might be right up your alley. Be warned, though, despite having a massive shield, heavy armor, and nerves of steel, some of the weapons you'll use while leveling as a Gladiator may seem lacking. Don't worry, though. I'm sure all the ladies want to hear about your epic dagger. Yeah. Anyway, let's start by taking a look at the Gladiator's guild. It is found in the Colosseum in Ulda. There is an Ethernet crystal near the guild for easy access, but if you're lost or new, the guild can be accessed through this double hallway directly across the city exit to Western Thanalan. The Gladiator's skill set is very basic, and none of the skills have confusing descriptions. It's a great starter class for anyone unfamiliar to MMOs because of its straightforward playstyle. You start with Fast Blade at level 1. This is just a basic attack that you will use in addition to your auto attack damage. Fast Blade does combo into several other moves later on, though. Also, the animation for it is actually one of my favorites, even if you are using a dagger sometimes. At level 2, the Gladiator learns Rampart. This is a great defensive cooldown that reduces all incoming damage by 20% for 20 seconds. It does have a fairly limiting cooldown of 90 seconds, so make sure you save it for when you need it. When you reach level 4, you'll learn Savage Blade. On its own, Savage Blade deals a rather unimpressive amount of damage. When comboed after Fast Blade, however, Savage Blade receives a respectable boost to its output. Savage Blade also generates extra enmity, or threat, on the targeted hits. This extra threat is applied even if it is not used in a combo, but remember that in a combo, Savage Blade will deal more damage, and, consequently, more threat. At level 6, you'll gain the Fight or Flight ability. This is actually a purely offensive cooldown, granting the Gladiator 30% extra physical damage for 20 seconds. Fight or Flight is most useful early on for speeding up the Gladiator's slightly slower kill rate. It can also be used as a moderately effective panic button to increase your damage if you think the enemy might kill you before you kill it. Level 8 grants the Gladiator the Flash skill. Now, Flash is the bread and butter of Gladiator tanking. It is a short-range, non-damaging AoE ability that generates very large amounts of enmity. You will use this skill often when tanking for a group, so it's important to get a feel for just how large the skill radius is. Also note that Flash uses MP instead of TP. Using it too much can run you out of MP very quickly. Yet another thing to remember when using Flash is that it will aggro anything within range, even if the mob is not currently hostile towards you or your party. Mastering the nuances of this skill is a must if you want to be a successful Gladiator tank. When you hit level 10, you will learn Convalescence. Convalescence is a purely defensive 90-second cooldown that increases the effect of healing on you from spells or actions by 30% for 20 seconds. Use this when your healer needs help or when you need your own self-heals to have a little extra punch. At level 12, the Gladiator learns Riot Blade. On its own, Riot Blade deals the same damage as Savage Blade. When used in a combo after Fast Blade, however, Riot Blade gets a significant damage boost and restores some of your MP. It takes approximately 2 to 3 Riot Blade combos to restore the MP used by one Flash, so a careful balance between threat generation and MP restoration must be struck when tanking. After your level 15 quest, you will learn the Shield Lob skill. This is a short-range attack that deals moderate damage and generates extra enmity. It functions almost exactly like the Marauder's Tomahawk ability. Shield Lob is perfect for pulling enemies safely from a distance and for generating extra enmity at the start of a fight, allowing any damage-dealing classes you're grouped with to start attacking sooner without having to worry about stealing threat from you. Now that we've covered the basic gladiator skills, we can examine some of the cross-class skills you might find useful. When selecting these skills, you are probably better off picking ones that complement your defensive abilities. Remember, the gladiator does not boast a lot of offensive punch, so concentrating on your strengths will usually yield greater results than trying to compensate for your weaknesses. Along these defensive lines, conjurer class skills are excellent choices. You will get a lot of mileage out of Cure and Protect whether you're soloing or in a group. It's important to note that early on as a gladiator, Cure is not going to heal for a lot of health. It is, however, still a great choice for multiple situations. Other strong choices include the Marauder's Foresight for defense, the Pugilist Featherfoot for evasion, and the Lancer's Keen Flurry for parry. Having extra defensive cooldowns in your pocket for emergencies is never a bad thing, especially when you're tanking. You might also enjoy the Lancer's Feint for an additional attack and on-demand slow. Lastly, as with most classes, you can always pick up Second Wind from the Pugilist. It's an instant heal that doesn't cost any resources. In other words, it's like having a free potion on a separate cooldown. Never a bad choice, in my opinion. Remember, though, that the cross-class skills are always your personal preference. Some may be better suited to certain playstyles, but feel free to build your character the way you want. That should just about do it for our beginner-friendly rundown of the Gladiator class. Questions and comments are always welcome. The feedback I've gotten from these videos has been extremely helpful in the making of this tutorial series. And if you're enjoying these Final Fantasy XIV A Realm Reborn beginner tutorials, feel free to leave a like on the video. It's the best and easiest way to show your approval. Plus, seeing lots of likes makes me all giddy inside. Anyway, have a great time playing the game, good luck with your adventures, and I will see you all in the next tutorial video.